One very important feature in Less Annoying CRM is pipelines. A pipeline is a way to track any process or workflow from start to finish. And using one means you will never let another opportunity slip through the cracks. You can focus on the people who are the highest priority, and you can pull very detailed reports. A lot of our customers use pipelines for tracking things like sales leads, but pipelines can be customized for just about anything. So if you need to track recruiting or customer service tickets or business development operations, you can track all of that and more with pipelines. In this video, we'll cover how to use pipelines, how to customize your pipelines, and finally, we'll talk about pulling pipeline reports. Start on the contact or company record that you want to work through your pipeline. In that attach an item section, just select the pipeline that you want to attach. We have a simple lead pipeline listed here, but you could have a differently named pipeline or more than one pipeline to choose from. Just depends on your setup. Next, you'll choose the appropriate status for this contact or company and fill out any custom fields. It is almost always best practice to also save a note for a little bit of context and set yourself a task to complete the next thing, or you can assign that task to somebody else on your team. So that looks good, so we'll save it. Now I can tell exactly where this contact stands in my pipeline at a glance, and I'll use this badge to update their status whenever that time comes. Continue to move this contact through the pipeline, updating custom fields, taking notes along the way, until they've reached one of the closed statuses. This history is all logged on the contact, so I have a comprehensive view of their life in the pipeline. If you're using pipelines to track items that might repeat, such as orders or policies, you might attach a pipeline more than once to track each order or policy separately. So we just talked about adding a pipeline to a single contact, but if you have imported a file of new contacts or companies, you can also add them in bulk to a single stage of your pipeline from the finished import page. Just saves you a bit of time. We're going to talk through how to customize a pipeline in this section, but remember, coaches like me have helped thousands of customers set up and use their pipelines, so do not hesitate to reach out if you'd like some help with this part. Okay, let's get started. From your pipeline settings, you'll see whatever pipelines came with your account, which might be specific to your industry. I'd recommend taking a look at your existing pipeline setup by clicking this edit option, because you may just need to tweak a few things instead of building one from the ground up. We will look at the edit option in a second. If you do find that your existing pipelines don't work for what you're looking to track, just click here to add a new one to your account. We've got some templates that can be good starting points for pipelines, like if you need to track orders or customer service tickets, recruiting. Even if you do start with a template, it's still good to make sure that the name, the statuses, and the fields of that pipeline are exactly what you need. So let's click the Edit Pipeline option to see the inside of a pipeline's structure. You can change the name and the icon that shows up in your report here, and you can even assign this pipeline to a specific team. So check out our user section to learn more about teams. You'll see the status section of your pipeline first. The statuses in your pipeline are all the stages or the steps that reflect your process from beginning to end. The pipeline that I'm working on here is for leads, so I just need to add a few more statuses to make this accurate. Anything that is part of this active status column just means you're actively working through that process still, and you can reorder them however you need. All right, that looks good. So now I just need to make closed or end statuses that reflect all the ways that this process could end. Most of my leads will go into the sales one status, obviously, but I also need to report on leads that we did not capture. So normally you'll only have a couple of closed options. Okay, once your statuses look good, move down to the custom pipeline fields section. These fields are tracking more nuanced data about the process. So if you're tracking leads, maybe you want to know where a lead came from. Or you may also want to know what services they're interested in. You could create an interested in checkbox list. So as you're adding custom fields, just consider the reports that you may want to see. If you want to filter or see a particular list, it's a good bet to add that information as a custom field for tracking purposes. Cool. Now that your pipeline is customized, you can start putting people or companies through it. The contact or company is great for seeing all the pipeline activity with an individual, but use the pipeline report to see all of your leads in one place. The contact or company's basic information is right here, and you can easily view their pipeline information on the right on that badge. Just click it to update the pipeline's info. You can set a task or take a note from here. Your whole team can also access this report to view one another's progress, but you could also filter it to see a specific team member's work in the pipeline. You can always export to Excel to calculate total values or print a PDF to send a copy off. You can also use these filters on the left to pull some specific reports. So maybe you want to focus in on just your prospects. Filtering by status lets you narrow in on them. Or pull a report on all the sales that you won last month for a specific service of yours. So I'll add this add a filter option to filter by my custom field and find everyone who is interested in a specific service. If you're tracking orders, you could find all of your completed orders for last month and export that list to total up last month's sales. The possibilities here are kind of endless, so try stacking a few filters to get the report that you need. Once you have started using the pipeline, you can always go back and add another status or custom field in the future. That is it for pipelines, but do not hesitate to reach out if you have any questions.